Hey everyone, it's Vicky, and I'm here today to kind of do a follow-up video to the original video that I did on this. I purchased this handbag. This is the Dooney and Burke Florentine Vechetta Satchel, and I purchased this probably about 7-8 months ago, and posted a video for you guys on my initial thoughts on it, and it was kind of like an unboxing in my first impressions of that handbag. Now I've had it for 7-8 months, something like that, and I am still carrying it. It is still my number one bag. I pretty much get a compliment, I would say, every single place that I carry this bag. It's very roomy. You can see I've got yarn in there. I'll go in there and show you guys what I've got inside. But it's an incredible bag. I cannot speak more highly of a bag in my collection. I truly can't. And I have a few designer handbags. I don't have, I have only one Louis Vuitton bag. It's the big, like, Neverfull bag that I've carried around. But nothing gets compliments quite like this one. The leather still just smells like a new rich car. Which, if you watch my original video, which I'll post down at the bottom, I just can't get over the smell of it, and I still can. It still smells wonderful. The leather has held up on it very nicely. If anything, it's just gotten softer. It does already have like a soft, buttery leather when you initially get it, but I think leather, when you just touch it and you really use it, it gets better. It just gets better with age, and I think it stays true for this bag, and it has survived. It's really, I sometimes use it as a diaper bag because it's so large. If I'm like running somewhere very quickly, I'll just throw like one diaper, you know, a sippy cup and just some snacks in my bag, because I don't always just want to carry a diaper bag. I do sometimes like having my own handbag, so it has acted as a diaper bag for me, but mostly just my like everyday handbag that I just tote around with me. Now, I live in Chicago, so our winter is pretty tough. It's been a tough winter. I think we've had like 51 inches of snow so far this winter, and I have to say that with that, like, cars are dirty, it snows, it's slushy, and sometimes I get nervous as to how the leather is going to react to that. And to be honest with you, it's reacted perfectly. You know, it's snowed on this purse, and it has gotten a little bit dirty from just, you know, when I carry it, I usually carry it like crossbody. And sometimes I've noticed it'll rub up against like a dirty car. So there's like a little dirty spot here. But other than that, when I was kind of looking through it, the tassels have held beautifully, and my daughter has like munched on these a couple of times because she really likes them. So that's held beautifully. The hardware, the gold hardware, has held up beautifully. I don't see any nicks or any scratches in it. This strap, like I said, I primarily wear it with a longer strap, kind of like this, like crossbody on me. And I don't see any wear and tear. It's not dirty. The hardware has held up beautifully, so there's nothing, like the threads are not coming undone. It's just truly held up beautifully. The interior as well, I have not had any issues. The zipper on top here has held up very nicely. Now, I've heard from other people and reviews that the more you use this, that this top portion would flip over. My bag has been pretty stuffed, so I haven't gotten that. As you can see, it hasn't really gotten to that point where this kind of flaps over. But maybe if I took stuff out of it, it would. As far as the handles go, I don't use the handles all that much because I have so much stuff in here and a baby to carry, so it's a lot easier for me just to use the larger one. But, you know, just for grabbing it or picking it up, I have obviously used the handles. There's no wear or tear on there. There's just a couple of scuff marks, just like I said, from me brushing up against the car and it getting dirty. Now, I'll go inside of this bag just to show you how much you can possibly fit into this bag. Now, I went to a Stitch and Bitch last night, which is like a get-together with your girlfriends where you can knit or crochet or whatever, and I really wanted to learn how to knit, so I brought along an entire skein, I think they're called skeins, of yarn with me, and then I purchased knitting needles, like circular knitting needles, because I had asked one of the girls, you know, what should I start with, and she had recommended knitting needles. I went to Joanne Fabrics and they recommended to start with these bamboo ones, which I'll show you what they look like. Now it has my, so this is knitting needles, they're 24 inches and a number 10, and I have started, so I was just starting yesterday because I was learning how to knit, and they're bamboo, which she said is nice because it doesn't slip off as easily like when you're first starting. And this is what they look like, and apparently it's easier because like your knots don't slip off, like they stay on the little circular needle. So that's in there. I'll probably keep that out because it doesn't need to be in back in my handbag. And then inside, and if you guys look at my video down below, you'll see how many pockets and things like that are inside of here. So I'll just pull out randomly. This is a Sephora bag, and in here I just keep coupons and things like that. And I have actually in here, this is hilarious. It's a lavender nail lacquer remover from Deborah Lippman. It's called the Stripper to Go for Go-Go Girls. And I think I got this in a Birchbox a long time ago. It says one mitt cleans all 10 nails. I haven't had it, but I like to have this in it as an emergency. There is nothing that I hate worse than chipped nail polish. Like, I cannot stand it. I'd rather not have nail polish on my nails than have chipped ones. Like, I just can't. So if a nail gets chipped or anything like that, I would just take off all the nail polish and just go with bare nailed than me having, like, you know, like half your nail. I can't handle it. It's like a weird OCD thing for me. So anyway, I throw in like little coupons, you know, things for like Victoria's Secret, Bath & Body Works. Those all kind of go in here just so I don't forget them. Then I have this Ulta thing because I was at Ulta getting more maracuja oil because I'm obsessed with that stuff. And then I have my Kate Spade wallet. It's a zip around. I absolutely love this wallet. I can't speak highly enough about it. It's just a wonderful wallet. You know, fairly standard. It has the credit card slots on the sides and then the zip in the center. It's pretty standard in there. I then have my Coach sunglasses. Sorry, I had gotten interrupted. The UPS guy came. But I really honestly wear glasses a lot of the time when I'm not filming or I'm just at home. I like to wear my glasses a lot, and sometimes when I run out, I was so annoyed that I had to put my contacts in order for me to wear sunglasses, because when you have lighter colored eyes, the sun, I think it irritates your eyes so much, especially with all this snow, and if there's any sun, it when it hits my eyes, I just can't see a thing. So I had gotten prescription sunglasses, and it's the best investment ever. Especially if you're a glass wearer, this is the best investment. It's also awesome because it hides so much. Like, if I put this on, I'm going to be blind. But when I put them on, it covers a good portion of my face. So then I'm running errands. I just leave them on. I know I look like a total, like, jerk when I go inside the store or post office or whatever wearing sunglasses. But whatever. I don't care. If someone, like, were to ask, I'd be like, oh, they're prescription and I don't have my glasses. Whatever. So those are in here. This isn't a hard case. Definitely, because they're prescription, I don't want anything to happen to them, and they're expensive. So, moving on. I had a pedicure not that long ago, and so these were just leftovers from that. And then I have this little, like, Chanel bag, and in here, I think, and I like carrying this because sometimes with the jewelry, if I'm wearing it, so, like, I don't know, sometimes, like, it gets annoying, like, if I have gloves on, for example, I had this ring on, and then I had gloves, so it didn't fit into the gloves, so I had to take it off, but I don't want to just throw it into my bag, because I don't want it to get scratched or ruined, so I like to throw jewelry kind of in this, and then this is just a Michael Kors tortoise watch that I have in here as well. I'll actually put that on, because I like it, and I think it'll go with my outfit. It's a really pretty, I really like it. I got this a couple of Christmases ago. I like it a lot. Then I have in here this little Chanel bag. Sorry, there's like dog hair flying over here. And in here I have pretty much all lip products. So if you look in here, it's like every lip product that, not every lip product I own, but a lot of them. This is the Buxom White Russian. I highly recommend this. If you guys have seen my review on like the full lips, which I used it today, if you guys want to see that, I'll have the review linked down below. But I like putting this on because it has a lip plumper in it. So I really like to accentuate my lips. So I like that a lot. I have blotting sheets. I don't need these as much in the wintertime like I do in the summertime. And then these are awesome, these NYX soft cream, buttery, whatever they're called. And then I have, this is really cool too, this Sexy Mother Pucker. This is from the Balm, and it's also a lip plumper. And then I have this Baby Lips. I'm just using it up because I don't really care for it. I don't think they're that great. What else do I have in here? Oh, this is a CoverGirl Jumbo Gloss Balm. And this is a really, really pretty color. It's actually fairly sheer, but beautiful. So it's like one of those jumbo lip pencils. And it looks intimidating because it's like that dark purple. But it's really, really pretty and fairly sheer. And then there's just a couple other lip products in there. And then I have my gloves. These are really great. I got these at Costco. And they're, they just say head on them. I don't know what that is. But I got them at Costco. They were inexpensive. They're really, really warm. They have a textured kind of hand surface. And then you can use your iPhone. You can use any smartphone with a fingertip. Which is why I really like them when I'm driving. Then this is my, like, I love this. I was able to purchase this because I, like, bet my husband all the time on things because I know I'm usually right. And got these Ray-Bans because he lost a bet. And I really love these. These are the, they fold down. So they're small, they fold down. I love them. I absolutely love these. So I keep them in their little Ray-Ban case. And I have the Fitbit in here. Like, I stopped using this just because it stopped working. So I actually have to follow up and get it fixed because it wasn't working. Then this is like a little card that comes with the Dooney and Burke handbag to like register it. This is one of those little like Kotex things. But once the tampons were out, I actually just have gum and another lip product in here. And then I have my headphones. These are the iPhone 5 ones, the little headphones that come with. I have this cute business card holder, and this was from Vistaprint. So I have my business cards and it has my name on there. And then I have a pen, some more business cards in here, my cell phone. This is my cell phone case. It's really cute and I like it because it protects the screen when I put it down on the surface. It protects my screen. And then I have a like almost empty thing of Tic Tacs in here. I have candy in here because I love candy. And every time I go to Michael's, I buy these. Like the Sweet Tart Mini Chewies. They're really, really good. I like those. I buy candy all the time. And then that's it. It's got the little strap for my keys, but I don't have my keys on there. And, oh, wait. I do have one more thing. See, this bag is so big. This is really cool. I had my husband buy this for me, I think over the holidays, and this is by the company Anker and K-E-R, and this is like a fast charge thing for my iPhone or my iPad. This thing is a lifesaver, number one, because a lot of times I run out of iPhone power when I'm out on the road, and I don't want to be that's just Hank, sorry guys. I don't want to be stuck out somewhere without having power on my phone, especially with the baby in the car. And then also, this has saved my butt because the when I do my Stella and Dot parties, I use my iPad. And so I've been places where I've like run out of juice, and I usually use it to check out. I don't have to, but I really like it to check out. And that has saved me from running out of battery. So this is what it looks like. And I've gotten about three charges on it, three full charges for my iPhone. And then it comes with like a little plug that you can plug it in. So I think this is $20 on Amazon. It's definitely been a lifesaver if you are running around and you're busy and you don't have any juice left on your smartphone or your iPhone. So that's pretty much it, guys. A follow up on this bag. I still love it. Love the color. I think it's brought so much joy to like this drab cold winter that we've had. I guess it is a little more floppy when I don't have stuff in it, but beautiful bag. I highly recommend this bag if you were ever on the fence with it. I've had it for almost a year now and I absolutely love it. We'll continue to use it. And just want to do a follow-up. I probably will do another follow-up for you guys in another 6 to 7 months or so, just to let you know full circle how I felt about this bag. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Hanky is down here with us, but he doesn't want to show himself. And I will see you guys again soon. Bye.